Good morning, students. From today, we are going to start our 10th chapter, Practical Geometry. In this chapter, we are going to learn how to draw a line parallel to the given line. Next, we are going to draw how to construct triangles with the given sides, all the three given sides, with two sides given, one angle is given. Like this, we are going to do the problems in this chapter. Let us start our exercise with the means chapter with introduction video. See, in this we are going to know the concepts, what we are going to learn in the chapter. See, the first one, it is construction of a line parallel to a given line. The meaning of this: think I have taken a line L. I wanted to draw a line parallel to this L. If I am going to draw a line parallel to this L, this may be using your scale, you can draw it. But there is a procedure to draw this line parallel to this given L. See, in your lines and segments, two lines are parallel and this is your transversal. By using this transversal, now we are going to draw a line parallel to this L. See, you can you remember that two lines L and M are parallel and P is the transversal. In this, the interior, the opposite interior angles are equal, means this angle is equal to this angle. Next, again, two lines are parallel, corresponding angles are equal. Using these concepts, we are going to draw a line parallel to this L. Means we are going to draw a line that is parallel to this L using these interior angle property equal property and corresponding angle equal property. To that, let me use this one. Means alternate interior angles are equal. So for this, let me draw a line anywhere. Let me draw a line on L. Let me name it as P. Now, using your compass, take any measurement, not a big measurement so that it comes out of this line. Take a small measurement, keep the metal point at P and draw an arc. Once again, let me repeat myself. Take any measurement using your compass, keep the metal point at P and draw an arc. With that same measurement, keep the metal point at this point Q. Let me write for that point Q. Keep the metal point at Q and draw an arc opposite wise. Once again, I am repeating, we have to draw a line parallel to this L. For that, I have just drawn a single line, and using your compass, take one small measurement, keep the metal point at P and draw an arc. This arc comes. With that same measurement, keep the metal point at Q and draw an arc. This arc comes. Now, after that, using that compass only, measure the distance between these two arcs. Using the compass, that is your rounder, measure the distance between these two arcs. Now, keeping the metal point at this point, draw an arc here. Now, when you draw a line, dotted line or whatever line, M, this line will be parallel to this line. That is, L will be parallel to M. Once again, I am repeating myself. See, we have to draw a line parallel to L. For that, I have taken the line and angles concept that alternate interior angles are equal. These two are interior angles. When you see this line and this line, these two are parallel lines and these two are alternate interior angles. They are equal. So for that, now I have drawn a line PQ on L, and using your rounder, compass rounder, I have taken some measurement, some small measurement. I have kept the metal point at P and drawn the arc. With that same measurement, I have kept the metal point at Q and drawn the arc here. Now with that rounder, I have measured the distance between these two arcs. And I have taken that measurement, kept the metal point at the meeting point here, and I have drawn an arc here. And I have drawn a dotted line. This line is M. Now you can see that L and M are parallel lines. So in this way we can draw a line parallel to the given line. In this way we are going to draw or use this concept in our exercise to draw a parallel line to the given line. Next concept we are going to learn in this chapter is drawing of triangles, means construction of triangles, construction of triangles. Construction of triangles. The first one we are going to see for given sides. We know that triangle is having three sides. So when all the three sides are given, like 3 centimeters, 5 centimeters, 7 centimeters. I have given these three sides and I have to construct a triangle. I have told you construction of triangles. First type of is given three sides. Triangle is having three sides. So, I have given three sides. Let us draw the rough figure. A, B, C. So ABC is a triangle. So let me take for here 3 centimeters. 3 centimeters can be here, here or here, anywhere. So likewise 5 centimeters can be anywhere. 7 centimeters, I am writing it according to my view. You can take the centimeters, the measurement anywhere. You can write 5 here, you can write 7 here, you can write 3 here, anywhere. But I am writing it in general. So here we see that AB is 3 centimeters, AC is 5 centimeters and BC is 7 centimeters. So a triangle will be coming like this. So seeing that BC, I have taken the base as 7 centimeters. So I am going to draw a line segment BC as 7 centimeters. Now, AB is 3 centimeters. So by using your scale and your rounder, measure 3 centimeters, keep the metal point at B and draw an arc. Means here we can see in a rough figure that AB is 3 centimeters. So using your scale and your rounder, measure 3 centimeters, keep the metal point at B and draw an arc. Okay, here. Next, we can see that AC is 5 centimeters. So, again, measure 5 centimeters using your scale and your rounder. Keep the metal point at C and cut the first arc. 5 centimeters. Now, join. My figure is not accurate because I am doing it freehand. You can do it by using your compass and your scale, your figure will be coming accurate. So this is your A point. So here it is 3 centimeters. Now here it is 5 centimeters. So in this way, we are going to construct the given triangle of three sides. When three sides are given, we are going to construct it like that. We can take any base but the second one we have to draw the arc by using a rounder. Next the arc again we by using the rounder. So we should see that the arcs meet at a point. It may be like this also. Your figure may be like this also. Your figure may be like this also. Anywhere you can see it. So this is your construction of a triangle when the three sides are given. Three sides of the triangle are given. Next comes when two sides and one angle is given. Let us assume for 3 centimeters, next 5 centimeters, and let it be 60 degrees. Two sides are given and one angle is given. How to construct a triangle for this? Let us draw a rough figure first. A, B, C. Let me take the BC for 3 or 5, anything, 3 centimeters. Next here 5 centimeters. And angle B here it is 60 degrees. So assuming that AB is 5 centimeters, angle B is equals to 60 degrees, and BC is 3 centimeters. So according to your rough figure, it is given like this. It is not the thing that I am every time assuming can be done. They are going to give the names of the triangle also, the sides of the triangle, which side is which centimeter according to that, and the angle also will be given. We have to construct according to that. So here, base here. Draw a line segment of 5 centimeters, AB here, BC of 3 centimeters, BC of 3 centimeters. Next given is angle B is equals to 60 degrees. So using your protractor, you have to measure 60 degrees and draw an line. So this is 60 degrees. Next, it is given as AB is 5 centimeters. So starting from keeping measuring using your scale and your circular, measure 5 centimeters and keep the metal point at B and draw an arc on this line. This is of 5 centimeters and the meeting point is A. So join the line with C. So this is your triangle that is formed when two sides and one angle is given. If angle C is given, your triangle will be like this. Here A, B, C, here 60 degrees. You can change, means according to the question, you can change the side where the angle is given. You can take here, see here it is coming, so it, 60 degrees is coming this side. B, I am taking here, so it is coming here. So according how they are going to give the question, we can see it. This is how we have to construct a triangle when two sides and one angle is given. Next, if one side and two angles are given, think that PQ is equals to 5 centimeters, angle Q is equals to 70 degrees and angle P is equals to 60 degrees. Here you can see that one side is given, so this will be the base. So draw line segment of PQ of 5 centimeters. Next, see, they have given as angle P is equals to 60 degrees. So using your protractor, measure 60 degrees and keep it. Next 70 degrees you have to keep PQ. Let it be for 70 degrees. You have to keep at Q. You have to see the left hand side inner this thing, and then you have to draw a line of 70 degrees. This is of 70 degrees and this will be of R. So this is how we have to construct. This is less than 90 degrees, so we have to see the right hand scale of the protractor. This is we are keeping on the left hand side, so we have to see the left hand side of the scale of the protractor for 70 degrees. So this is how we have to construct the triangle of given one side and two angles. The same way we are going to use in these are all the concepts we are going to use for our exercises to be done in this practical geometry. We are going to use all these concepts, and in this way we are going to construct the line segments, next the triangles, that is when all the three sides are given, that is SSS criterion, two sides and one angle, that side angle side criterion, next three angles and two angles and one side, that is angle side angle criterion. These are the criterias which we are going to use for constructing our triangles. One more, it is right hand RHS criterion, that is, see till now we have seen for side criterion, side angle side criterion, where the two sides and one angle is given. Next angle side angle criterion, that is two angles and one side is given. Next RHS criterion means right angle hypotenuse side criterion, means in this one side will be given, either hypotenuse will be given, because right hand right angle, that is 90 degrees will be there, means in this one the triangle will be like this, means every time 90 degrees will be there. Sometimes side will be given x centimeters and hypotenuse will be given, means we have to, let me show it with an example. AB is equals to 7 centimeters, that is base, hypotenuse is equals to 9 centimeters, and we have to construct a right angle triangle, that is construct right angle triangle ABC. So here we can see that AB is given 7 centimeters. So AB as 7 centimeters. Next, here angle A is 90 degrees. So angle A will be 90 degrees. So hypotenuse is given as 9 centimeters. So from here to here, using your scale and your rounder, you have to measure 9 centimeters and draw an arc on this line, that is 90 degrees, and you have to join these two lines. So this is 9 centimeters. So this one name is C. So this is A, B, C. This is your right angle triangle. So these are the concepts, these are the criterions which we are going to use for our solving our problems. First one is side, next side, angle, and RHS, right angle hypotenuse side. So these are the criterions which we are going to use for our solving our exercises, and I have told you how to draw a line parallel to the given line segment by using our lines and angles, that is alternate interior angles are equal, using that concept how to draw a line parallel to the given line. So let us continue in our next class.